more.
And you put the bell peppers in the end. Bell pepper in the end because pinakamadali.
While we're waiting for this to cook,
you want to wait until you reduce the liquid until it's a little thicker already. In which case, you know, when you reduce, when the term reducing the liquid is really evaporating the water from a liquid, from a liquid sauce or a substance like what we have here. And then when you evaporate water, what is left is a concentration of flavors. Okay? Mm-hmm. And so imagine all that beef goodness. What else did we throw in there? We had some nice olive oil with garlic, tomatoes, onions, of course, the chorizos, which, you know, is definitely going to become a very strong contribution to the flavors of your caldereta. We'll throw in some bell peppers later. Sometimes they throw in the canned pimientos na eh, if you notice, diba? Mm-hmm. And then, of course, you know, the added
olives,
you know, for color and, you know, and texture also. Then, of course, to taste, you want to adjust. If you need more pepper or a little bit more salt, that is definitely something that you will leave to, you know, to someone like yourself to decide how much you want to season.
But when do you put this? When it's
I guess we're about ready here now. We can throw in, I mean, you know, like in the last 3 minutes of your cooking, you don't really want to overcook your vegetables. In fact, if anything, you can eat this raw, eh, diba? So I'll throw in the red and green bell peppers because it's Christmas. Corny, ba?
We're going to see a lantern there somewhere.
Yeah, somewhere, right? Uh-huh. It's going to light up. So in this case, I think traditionally, caldereta is a little bit on the spicy side. But then again, like I said, the bell pepper provides, you know, a bit of heat in your cooking, and if you want more heat, that you would use the more fiery peppers. In this case, you know, the little bird's eye chilies, maybe one or two of that you throw in there. It gives you a lot of heat already. But, you know, since this is a Christmas dish and you've got, you know, diners of all ages coming into play here, you don't really want to get your caldereta all that spicy, because then maybe perhaps the children or the older people are not going to
So you're still putting pepper? That.
Well, just a little. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, and then I think we're almost about ready here. Okay, let me just throw this in, okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wanted us to learn, before we go into a break into our next recipe, is how do you actually present it on the table? And given the amount that you've prepared for, make sure that everybody has a good serving or a good helping. It's not a trick that I want you to give us, but, you know, how do you make it, how do you make each one be able to taste and enjoy a good portion of what you prepared? Would it be like, is it a combination of that beef caldereta, and then you have to have chicken, you have to have fish, and then you have to have soup, and then it's easier to prepare all of them in medium sizes?
Right. I mean,
para yung combinasyon.
Okay, the common mistake with people planning for parties is that if they've got 20 guests, they make 20 portions of each.
Yes.
In which case, unless you have man-size appetites, you end up with more food than you really need. Okay? Mm. So the thing here is, if you're doing a party for 20, you don't want to do 20 portions of caldereta and 20 portions
not unless it's steak
of pastel.
So you have to have beef.
Unless it's steak. Yes,
diba?
In which case you count you can count the number of pieces there. And here naman in the caldereta, you don't really want to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah.
Right? So you just want to have enough of your extenders, your potatoes, your vegetables, your sauce, you know, which when you think about it is also something that you can consider as a hearty addition to, say, your plate of rice. You put a little sauce over
kasi
your
diba,
rice
in the Filipino party scene, especially during Christmas, They talk about how delicious the food was, mm-hmm. but sometimes they also complain kulang eh, naubusan sila ng pagkain.
Oh, correct. Okay.
Parang you have a tendency as a Filipino host to always give more and have an excess of everything mm-hmm. because you want your guests coming home. Mm-hmm. Wait, ang dami-daming pagkain sa party ni Myrna. Mm-hmm. Yung ganon. Mm-hmm. Is that an
kasi,
attitude? That,
yeah, at saka kasi, you know, our feeling is if we serve less, it's parang tinipid natin oh. yung mga visitors natin. Oh. No? But in our case, ayaw rin naman natin na masyadong maaksaya.
Oh, oh.
Kasi unang-una magastos. Oh,
yeah.
Diba?
Yeah.
So the thing to do here is if you have a variety of dishes, then, you know, chances are there is an even distribution.
Yeah.
You know, of food on the plate.
And you have to plan. And
yeah.
you have to plan.
Whereas if you called your family and said, all right, I'm only serving caldereta and rice mm-hmm. and, I don't know, a salad perhaps, mm-hmm. then definitely you're going to have to prepare
more.
Okay. And, you know, if you've got 20, then definitely at the very minimum, you must have about
okay, so where do you put this beef caldereta? What kind of a dish?
Luto yeah, na I think we're kind of done luto here. And the thing, check mo lang naman dyan kung yung potatoes mo luto na eh.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
So I guess we're pretty done. I think we're ready now.
It's done.
Yeah, it's done.
Beef caldereta. The recipe found in the culinaria book.
Yes.
And a also, collection of...
And also in my cookbook.
In your cookbook.
Yes.
And now...
Can you smell the chorizo?
I can. I can smell the bell pepper.
Yeah.
I can smell not the olives. But why do you have a lot more than my plate?
No, because this is...
I'm going to get from there. I thought that's for you and this is for me.
No.
Okay.
Like, we're making a recipe here that's good for about 4 people, right?
Okay, I thought it was just for you and then...
No.
I'm just going to taste.
No.
Okay,
so here we go.
Also that.
And let's just pour all that goodness on.
So this kind of beef caldereta with this consistency of the sauce mm-hmm. is rightfully placed in a dish like this. What do you call this
dish?
I don't
know. What do you
Because
think?
Some people put it in a bowl.
Yes, you can.
Maski na hindi ganun karami, it's not like a soup kind.
Is there a rule there?
No.
No, not really. I mean, in this case, I just like using wide open mouth.
Because you want to show it.
Yeah.
And what is that? I've been watching this. I thought it was part of our decor.
It's an Italian oregano. It's an herb which is popularly used for garnish and for cooking. And in this case, I'm very proud to say I grew this.
In at home?
At home. Very easy to grow. And so, you know, just want to throw
it
in there, you know. I mean, kumbaga, I mean, what's a leaf or two that makes a dish a little bit more extra special
yeah.
in terms? Okay, so let's have a taste.
I will. I want it with
an olive, a potato,
and a bell pepper,
and a little sauce.
A little sauce.
Uh-huh.
No oregano.
Oh, you want to sprinkle in oregano?
I do. I want to taste
sure.
it.
Sure, go ahead.
Okay.
Here, why don't we... Here.
Okay,
there
so...
You go. See if you like that. Is it tender enough?
It is so tender.
Mm-hmm.
It is so tender. It is... I think this is the real caldereta.
Is it?
It smells like it. It's...
Looks like it. I hope it tastes like it.
It must be caldereta. Our special recipes are on our Facebook page. We'll take a break. Eat some more later on when we return. A special chicken dish. Stay with us, please.